strongly spoken against caste issues, and their artworks have challenged the mainstream Brahminical notions of art and aesthetics. And these artworks have covered wide range of issues, starting from historical moments in the movement to contemporary issues, Buddhism and Buddhist philosophy, all those things. So that's why this show has been helped out by Sudhara Kolbe and his organization Photography Promotion Trust, and he only suggested me to have an exhibition around the area. That's how it developed, and basically we have 12 artists here, and artists have spoken about issues like Kerlanji, where in a Dalit community, an entire Dalit family was killed by the upper caste. So there are paintings which show the fight of people against such injustices, the problems that these communities have to go through. And there are issues like Mahar Satyagraha, which has been done by Uttam Ghosh. So basically it shows the struggle to drink water from a tank, which was led by Ambedkar. So the struggle of Dalit communities for even such basic things is the main intention to show such painting. There is the perspective of Dalit feminism, which has been covered by Jaya Dharote. So she shows the objectification of the Dalit woman's body by the Brahmin upper caste male, and how the untouchability disappears when it comes to taking sexual advantage of the woman. And there are paintings by another painting by Uttam Ghosh, where he pays tribute to Vilas Khobre, and he puts forward a unity of the Ambedkarites and the left to fight against caste. There are paintings by Sani Savarkar, where he uses a different kind of technique of etching to show the issues of untouchables. So there's one painting, Untouchable, with a dead cow. So he is showing how cow, which is such a sacred animal for the Hindus, it becomes unsacred and untouchable, and then the untouchable man has to carry it when it's dead. So that kind of irony is in his work. Then another painting by Sagi is Manu, where he tries to capture the real image of Manu, who is thought to be, in terms of Brahminical scriptures, he is said to be a Brahmin, he is a learned man. But basically he has tried to show the real ugly face of Manu with scars and big eyes. And another painting by Savi is this Devdasi, where the woman Devdasi, she has a scar on her stomach showing the numerous numbers of children that she has, the violence and sexual abuse that she goes through. And there is painting Blue Scream by Vinay Avtare, where he is showing the scream of the Dalit community, which is not heard by the state, which is patronized and which holds all the power. And there are paintings by Vinu, where in one of the paintings he shows the invisibility of the common man, and he is showing making visible the rejected, where the invisibility of the common man, he doesn't have a face and his issues doesn't get addressed. And in another painting he has shown a broken statue of Buddha. Basically it comes from an experience where an entire village was attacked and because they had established a Buddha statue in their village. So these kind of acts of violence against such simple things like putting a statue of Buddha in their community. So these are issues which need to be talked about. There are other paintings, like Nandu Kumar Jogdan, in one of his paintings he is talking about how people use religion as a driving force for them. They are so circled, their life is so surrounded by religion that they do not think beyond it. And that's how basically the concept of this entire exhibition is to talk about issues which have not been talked, basically caste. So there are many social issues which have often been reflected in paintings, but caste is something which has never been spoken about and which artists actually fear. So basically we have tried to bring about the concept of Dalit art. So by that I actually mean any art form which is against the caste oppression, and it doesn't mean that the person has to be Dalit to make a Dalit art. So it's basically about what painting is being done and not who is doing the painting. Basically in Dalit art we speak about Dalit consciousness, Dalit subjectivity, and even if you are from some other caste than Dalit, there needs to be a reflexivity of where you stand vis-a-vis the Dalit movement. So that's what Dalit art is in a sense. It's not just political art form. We want to create a Dalit aesthetics to look at paintings from a Dalit consciousness and to break away the mainstream notion of aesthetics and to have a not, I won't say different aesthetics, but to have challenge the mainstream and, you know, modify it according to the to other perspectives. Thank you. Yeah. So you can see on the painting.